Ever find yourself referencing a study in conversation that you didn't actually read? I was having coffee with a friend of mine the other day, and I said, you know, I read a new study that says coffee reduces the risk of depression in women. But really, what I read was a tweet. And that tweet had a link to the New York Times blog, where a guest blogger translated the study findings from a Life Science article, which got its original information from the Harvard School of Public Health news site, which cited the actual study abstract, which summarized the actual study published in an academic journal. It's like the 6 degrees of separation, but with research. That doesn't seem right. But accessing original research is difficult because academics aren't regularly engaging with popular media. And you might be asking yourself, why aren't academics engaging with popular media? To understand why scholars aren't engaging with popular media, you first have to understand how universities work. First, scholars produce research in their fields. To fund their research, they apply for public and private grants, and after the research is finished, they write a paper about their findings. Then they submit that paper to relevant academic journals. Then it goes through a process called peer review, which essentially means that other experts are checking it for accuracy and credibility. And then, once it's published, for-profit companies resell that information back to universities and public libraries through journal and database subscriptions. So, that's the system. Research, write, peer review, publish, repeat. My friends and I call it feeding the monster. And you can see how this might create some problems. The first problem is that most academic research is publicly funded, but privately distributed. Just 5 corporations are responsible for distributing most publicly funded research. In 2014, just one of those companies made $1.5 billion in profit. It's a big business. I bet you can see the irony here. If the public is funding academics' research, but then we have to pay again to access the results, it's like we're paying for it twice. And the other major problem is that most academics don't have a whole lot of incentive to publish outside of these prestigious subscription-based journals. Universities build their tenure and promotion systems around the number of times scholars publish. So books and journal articles are kind of like a form of currency for scholars. Academics are not rewarded for publishing with popular media. So this is the current academic ecosystem, but I don't think it has to be this way. Let's start by discussing access. Universities can begin rewarding scholars for publishing not just in these subscription-based journals, but in open access journals as well as on popular media. Access isn't just about being able to get your hands on a document or a study. It's also about making sure that that document or study is easily understood. So let's talk about translation. What if scholars were able to take the research that they're doing and translate it on popular media and be able to engage with the public? In fact, there's a term for scholars who regularly engage with popular culture and contribute to public knowledge. They're called public intellectuals. This is Dr. Sanjay Gupta. CNN has carved out a space for him to discuss complicated medical terminology and break down medical research using language that's easy for the public to understand. But at the same time, he's a practicing neurosurgeon and an assistant professor of neuroscience at Emory University. By showing the public how their tax dollars are being used to fund research, they can begin to redefine universities' identities so that universities' identities are not just based on a football team or the degrees they grant, but on the research that's being produced there. And when there's a healthy relationship between the public and scholars, it encourages public participation in research. A functioning democracy requires that the public be educated and well-informed. Instead of research happening behind paywalls and bureaucracy, wouldn't it be better if it was unfolding right in front of us? I believe in inclusive, democratic research that works in the community and talks with the public. I want to work and research in an academic culture where the public is not only seen as a valuable audience, but a constituent, a participant, and in some cases, even the expert.
Education is the ultimate idea worth spreading. That's why we've launched InnovateEd, a program that helps educators develop their brightest ideas and share them with the world. Learn more at ed.ted.com/edtalks. Join the movement to amplify educator voices.